Hey everybody, today is August 20th and it's the Feast of the Prophet Samuel. The Orthodox Church celebrates the lives of the righteous from the Old Testament as well as the New Testament as saints. And so today I want us to take a moment to look at an important prophet from the Old Testament, the prophet Samuel, who lived in the 12th century before Christ. Now, something for us to be aware of, when we're looking at the Old Testament, sometimes when we're looking at the Orthodox Study Bible, and comparing it to other English translations, we're gonna see some different names in the Old Testament, some different names of the books, for example, and some of the order and structure of those books. Now, the Orthodox Church uses an older translation of the Old Testament called the Septuagint that was translated into Greek in the second century before Christ, and it was what the apostles and what the Lord were using for the Old Testament. Now, in the Septuagint, the books of the Bible that we may know of as 1 Samuel, 2 Samuel, 1 Kings, and 2 Kings are all called kingdoms. So we have 1st, 2nd, 3rd, and 4th kingdoms. And the life of the prophet Samuel comes from that first book, 1 Kingdoms, also known as 1 Samuel. His life is held within those first 25 chapters of that first book in that series. So let's look a little bit at the details of his life. The first thing that we need to know is that his father was named Elkanah, and Elkanah had two wives. His first wife was Peninnah, and the second was Hannah. Peninnah had children, but Hannah was unable to have children. And she, as well as many women of her age that were unable to have children, felt as though God had kept them from having children or had done something to say that they were unworthy. So she was very upset and she was sad that she wasn't able to have children, just like Saint Anna, the mother of the Theotokos, and Elizabeth, the mother of the prophet John. They all had the same sadness of being able to have children. So they prayed to God, and Saint Hannah prayed to God that she would be able to have children. And so God gave her the blessing of being able to give birth to Samuel. So when Samuel was 3 years old, she took him to the place where the ark was kept, the Holy of Holies. Even though there wasn't a temple at the time, the Jews would go and gather at the ark. And so there she took Samuel there when he was 3 years old and took him to live with the priest Eli. And there he was raised in holiness. And there's a lot of different details that we can go into his life, but the important part is that he was revealed to be a seer and a prophet at a very young age, and being able to hear the voice of God speaking to him directly. And so he went on to become a judge, and the last judge of the Israelites. And through his time as a judge, he was shown to be a righteous individual, a righteous judge. And because of that, the people of Israel desired a king. So instead of desiring that God would rule them directly, they decided they wanted a king, just like all of the non-Jewish world had. So eventually God said, fine, I'll give them a king. And it was through the hands of the prophet Samuel that he anointed the first two kings of the Israelites. So he anointed first Saul, and then he anointed David. And one of the things about the prophet Samuel that we learn is through this interaction with Saul and David. And one of them is that when the Lord rejected Saul for his inability to be a proper king, prophet Samuel mourned for him. He wasn't self-righteous. He wasn't saying, fine, I'll just do a new one. He was sad that Saul didn't live up to that expectation, and he mourned him, and he grieved that. So this is showing something about his compassion as a leader. And the other thing is that we see that he was an example of holiness and of righteousness, and that he interceded for the people before God. And we see this in 1 Samuel 12:23, or 1 Kingdoms 12:23, where Prophet Samuel says, far be it from me that I should sin against the Lord in ceasing to pray for you, for the people of God. And what's really wonderful about this is that we see that the prophet Samuel is saying that he would be sinning against God if he weren't praying and interceding for the people. And this is exactly what makes a saint a saint. And this is what makes a Christian, is that we are people of prayer. We are people who pray for those around us, and we do not cease to intercede for all of the world before the Lord. And so this is a couple things that we can take from the story of the prophet Samuel, that he was a compassionate leader, that he prayed, he was a person of prayer, and that he prayed for other people actively, and that he saw that if he weren't doing that, he would be sinning before the Lord. And so this is something we can be doing as well. And lastly, I wanted to give a shout out to a book about the prophet Samuel called The Seer by Metropolitan Hierotheos of Naphmactos. And this is translated from Greek into English. And it's a really great resource for all of us to learn more about an Orthodox perspective on an important Old Testament prophet. And so this is what the book looks like. And on it, you can see there's an icon of the prophet Samuel. And so today, I hope that you will dig into scripture a little bit more. Go look at 1 Kings, also known as 1 Samuel. Read the first 25 chapters, read a couple of chapters, and start to learn more about such an important figure in the life not only of the Israelites, but of the church before the incarnation as well. Amen.